Have you ever wondered why, no matter what you try, that ringing in your ears just won't stop? Maybe you even talked to your physician about your tinnitus and been told you just have to learn to live with it. It's exhausting. Sleepless nights, constant anxiety, and frustration leads many people to spend thousands of dollars on supplements, gadgets, or miracle cures that just don't deliver. Today, I'm going to show you exactly which tinnitus treatments are backed by real scientific evidence and which ones you can ignore. I'm Dr. Layne Garrett, founder of Timpanogos Hearing and Tinnitus, and I'm proud to say we are one of the founding Modern Tinnitus Specialty Centers in the United States, and we've helped thousands of patients overcome tinnitus over the last 20 years. I've seen firsthand what works and what doesn't, and I'm here to share the truth with you. So if you're ready to finally get clarity about tinnitus treatments, stay with me. Let's start by busting the biggest myth once and for all. If you have tinnitus, you get it. It's not just the sound itself, the ringing, buzzing, and hissing. It's the mental toll that it takes. The anxiety, the sleepless nights, and that constant sinking feeling that you might never experience silence again. It can feel incredibly isolating. So you go online, desperate for a solution, and then you're thrown into the wild west of miracle cures. You see shady websites promising a magic pill, usually with flashy, all natural labels that will just silence the noise for good. The reason this market exists is pretty simple. Tinnitus is a complex condition without a single easy cure. The sound isn't coming from your ear. It's being generated by your brain, often as a reaction to hearing loss or other types of damage in the auditory system. That complexity creates a vacuum and misinformation rushes in to fill it. And because many doctors tell you it's just something you have to live with it, millions of desperate people are pushed right into the arms of anyone offering even a sliver of hope, no matter how baseless that claim is. One of the biggest myths of all is that nothing can be done, and millions of people hear that from their doctor every year. What boggles my mind is that the American Academy of Otolaryngology Head Neck Surgery, the professional organization for ear, nose, and throat specialists in the United States, actually published guidelines for treating tinnitus all the way back in 2015. These guidelines were developed through years of scientific research on what's effective and what's not. So let's get into what doesn't work, because avoiding these dead ends is the first real step towards relief. The official clinical practice guidelines are crystal clear about what to avoid. First up, dietary supplements. This is probably the biggest scam online. You'll see ads for ginkgo biloba, zinc, melatonin, and all sorts of proprietary blends. These claims are always about increasing blood flow or giving your ear special nutrients to stop the ringing. But what does the science say? The guidelines explicitly state that doctors should not recommend supplements for treating tinnitus. Study after study after study has found they work no better than a sugar pill. Remember, natural doesn't mean effective, and sometimes these supplements can cause side effects or interfere with other medications you might be taking. You know, it feels like there should be a pill to treat tinnitus, but it's not that simple. As of now, the FDA has not approved any drug specifically to treat tinnitus. Sometimes doctors might prescribe medications off-label, like certain antidepressants or anti-anxiety drugs, and while those might help you cope with the stress or depression that come with tinnitus, they are not recommended to treat the sound itself. Evidence just isn't strong enough, and they can bring a host of their own side effects. And what about acupuncture or magnetic stimulation? These are popular alternative treatments. While acupuncture is an ancient practice with many uses, the scientific proof for its effect on tinnitus simply isn't there. Likewise, transcranial magnetic stimulation has been studied, but the results have been shaky and inconclusive at best. The official guidelines do not recommend it as a routine treatment for tinnitus. The main takeaway here is that while it's so tempting to try something, these common solutions all lack serious scientific evidence to show that they actually work. If you've wasted time or money on any of these things and this video is making you feel seen, please do me a favor and hit the like button. It really helps YouTube know that this is important information for others living with tinnitus to find. And if you want more honest health deep dives like this, please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification below. Thanks. All right. So what's the good news? While there isn't a magical pill for tinnitus, there are absolutely strategies backed by strong science that can seriously reduce the toll tinnitus takes on your life. These are the treatments you'll find in the official clinical guidelines. The focus isn't on making the sound vanish completely, but on retraining your brain's reaction to it so it stops causing distress. It's a process called habituation, and it's completely achievable. Now, tinnitus is most commonly caused by damage in the auditory system, and hearing aids can be a game changer for most. In fact, There are over 40 peer-reviewed scientific studies showing that hearing aids can effectively treat tinnitus. The American Academy of Otolaryngology guidelines state that hearing aids should be considered a first-line treatment even for tinnitus patients who might otherwise be considered marginal candidates for hearing aids based on their hearing loss alone. By amplifying the sounds you've been missing, your brain begins to receive that stimulation it's been lacking, which helps the tinnitus fade into the background. Next up, educational and counseling based on cognitive behavioral therapy. This is a type of therapy where you learn to identify and reframe the negative thoughts you have about tinnitus. It helps you break the vicious cycle that sound causes anxiety, the anxiety makes you focus on the sound, and that focus makes it seem louder or more threatening. Study after study have shown that this is incredibly effective for reducing the stress, anxiety, and depression caused by tinnitus, and for restoring people's quality of life. It puts you in the driver's seat. And then sound therapy. This is a very broad category, but the two main types are masking and tinnitus retraining therapy. Masking is about turning up the external sounds to cover up the tinnitus. While masking can be good for short-term relief, it doesn't really help the brain habituate and is not recommended as a long-term solution. Tinnitus retraining therapy, though, is different. It's not about drowning out the ringing. It's about enriching your surroundings with neutral, non-threatening sounds like white noise, nature sounds, or even just a fan, to give your brain something else to listen to, making the tinnitus less noticeable. Combined with directive counseling, it can be a successful therapy, but it takes quite a long time. Sound therapy isn't formally recommended in the Academy guidelines as a standalone treatment, but it is listed as an option that can be helpful for some people. Now I want to talk about something genuinely exciting that's a different approach that we've typically taken for treatment of tinnitus. It's something called Lenire. It's the first and only device to get FDA approval for treating tinnitus. So what is it? Lenire works by stimulating two areas of your brain at the same time. You wear special headphones that play a sequence of tones, and at the same time, a small little device on your tongue provides very gentle electrical pulses. The idea is that by stimulating the hearing nerve and the nerves in the tongue together, you help retrain the part of the brain creating that phantom sound, helping your brain to pay less attention to it over time. The clinical data behind Lenire is very impressive. Large-scale, worldwide trials have shown that a high percentage of people experience significant improvement. Data from a recent US trial showed that 91.5% of patients had a clinically meaningful reduction in tinnitus severity after just 12 weeks of using the device. And studies have shown that these improvements last at least a year after treatment. So with all that said, where should you begin? The single most important step is to get a proper evaluation from a professional. Go see an audiologist who specializes in tinnitus treatment. They'll do a full hearing evaluation to see if hearing loss is a factor and rule out other underlying medical issues that might be causing the noise. If needed, they'll refer you to an ENT for further evaluation. Once you have that information, you can have an informed conversation about the options we've talked about: hearing aids, education and counseling, sound therapy, Lenire, or a combination of these treatments. The main thing I want you to leave with is this: there is real hope. While there isn't an instant cure, there are proven ways to manage tinnitus and get your life back. You can learn to push the sound back into the background, strip it of its emotional power, and return to a living, peaceful, fulfilling life. I see it every day. So we've busted the myths around supplements and unproven treatments for tinnitus, and we've focused on what the science actually says works. Proven tools like cognitive behavioral therapy, hearing aids, and the promising FDA-approved technology like Lenire. The way forward isn't about finding a miracle. It's about using evidence-based solutions to manage your tinnitus effectively. Your journey to a quieter life starts with one informed step. I've put links in the description below, one of which is to get a free copy of my book, Take Your Life Back, which goes even deeper into tinnitus treatment options. The other links are there to help you find audiologists who specialize in tinnitus treatment near you. Thanks for watching.